students. Continuing with our chapter tissues, which includes plant and animal tissues. In the last slide, we started with the introduction part. We also understood the relationship between tissue, between organ, organ system, and organism. We had started with the first important part of this chapter, that is plant tissue. Can you all please try to recollect how many types of plant tissues are present? There are two important types, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Okay? In the meristematic tissue, we understood that depending upon its location, the meristematic tissue is further divided into two important types. What do you understand by meristematic tissue? By the way, meristematic tissues are those which are rapidly dividing, which are made up of rapidly dividing cells and which continuously keeps on adding cells to the plant body. Okay, now as I said, depending upon its location, they are further divided into two types, classified into two types, apical meristem, also called as terminal meristem, and cambium meristem, also called as lateral meristem. Okay, so apical present at the apexes or the tips, lateral present at the cambium or the bark of the stem. Right, so these are the two types of meristematic tissue. We even understood about the characteristics of the meristematic tissue. The important characteristic was it lacks vacuole. I hope you all remember there were two question marks around this point. The question mark, I had completed I had even mentioned the answer for those question marks. The answer to that question, the answer was that since those cells are involved in the process of cell division, vacuoles would cause hindrance in the process of cell division. That's the reason that there are no vacuoles in that type of the cells. Okay, so this was all that we studied about the meristematic tissue in the last session. In today's session, we need to start about the next type of the plant tissue, that is the permanent tissue. Now, what are permanent tissues? The rapidly dividing cells, what happens to these cells? After a particular stage, they stop the process of cell division. And what do? They take up a particular function by taking up a particular shape. Now, these cells might be living cells if they have nucleus in them. They might be dead cells if they lack nucleus after the process of cell division. So, if they don't have nucleus, they can turn into dead cells. Okay? So, these different types of the cells what I am talking about are none other than your permanent tissues. So, as I have mentioned in this point, what are permanent tissues? The cells which have lost their ability to divide and which have taken up the permanent shape and perform some permanent function. They may be living. When do we call them as living? If they have nucleus, or they may be dead. When are they called as dead? If they have no nucleus in them. Okay? Now, even these permanent tissues, like your meristematic tissues, are further being classified into three different types. But here, their classification is not based on their location, but the classification is based on their functions. Okay? So, depending upon their three important functions, what are the three important functions? They are either protective in function, or supportive in function, or conductive in function. Now, what do you understand by these three important functions? Students, when I say protective in function, what can you all think? How can a plant be protective in function? Like, what are the what tissues can protect the plant? If you consider a plant body or compare a plant body with an animal body or a human body, in human body, the skin is the protective layer, right? Same pattern, my dear students, the plant has the epidermal layer of the cells throughout its body. on the surface of the leaves, on the surface of the stem, on the surface of the roots, right? So this epidermal layer of the cells is what? This layer of the cells would act as the protective layer of the cells. And as you all know, the definition of the tissue says that it is the group of the cells, right? So this group of the cells, which is protective in function, would be one type of your permanent tissue, okay? That is protective in function. Second function, as I said, supportive in function. Now, what tissue can work as supportive in function? Here you can come across multiple tissues in the plant body that can be supportive in function. But can you all think of how can the plant stand throughout its life in one position? Have you all ever seen a plant jumping or hopping anytime? No. The plants cannot do any such actions, right? The plants are steady at their position. Okay, so how can they be steady at their position? They cannot show any movements. They do not have any muscular tissue in their body. And all these stiffness or all these support in their body is thankfully because of the supporting tissues in their body. Okay, the third type of tissue which is present in the plant body is conducting tissues. Now, what do we understand by conducting tissues? Conducting tissue, means transportation tissues. Now, in the plant body, water and minerals needs to be transported. From where? Where do plants absorb water and minerals from? I hope you all are murmuring some answers. Yeah, it is from the roots. Okay, from the roots to the soil, right? So from the roots it has to be transported to all the parts of the plant body. Okay, so definitely the plant is going to require some or the other conducting tissue. Also, the food which has been synthesized in the plant body, it's not synthesized in all the parts of the plant body. It's synthesized only in the particular parts, and that part is the leaf. So from the leaf, it has to be transported to all the parts of the plant body. So definitely the plant is going to need certain conducting tissues also. Okay, so based on its functions, there are three different types of permanent tissues in the plant body. Let us have a look on all these three types of the conducting, all these three types of the permanent tissues. Starting with the first, that is protective in function. So these tissues are called as protective tissues. So how do the cells of the protective tissue look like? Definitely, the cells are with the thick walls. Now, can you all think of why do the cells have thick walls? Definitely, the function is protection. Jitne thick walls honge, utna zyada protection milega in that part of the plant body. Like for example, if you see the epidermal layer of the leaves, they secrete out a waxy substance that's called as cuticle. Okay, so jitna zyada cuticle ka secretion, utna transpiration ka process is less in the plant body. Okay, so this epidermal layer of the cells, which is present on the surface of the leaf, that behaves the protective layer in the protective tissue in the plant body. Okay, so yes, definitely the cells have thick cell walls. That is one of the important characteristics which you all have to keep in mind. And second, where are they present? They would be found on the entire surfaces of the plant body. When I say of the plant body, you can be specific, that is roots, stem and leaves, right? Second type of the permanent tissue, that is supportive tissue. This is being further classified into three different types: parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. Okay, parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. right? Now, what is parenchyma? We need to understand the characteristics of each and every tissue over here. Okay, please don't get confused. What is parenchyma? Now, parenchyma, if you see these cells, these are the cells of the parenchyma tissue. Okay, first of all, these are living cells. The dark color, this one, this is nothing but the nucleus. Okay, this what I have drawn, this is the cell wall. Right, this is the cell wall. This dark one is nucleus. Okay, and this one is the vacuole. So unlike your meristematic tissue or meristematic cells, here you have a large vacuole in the center. Because of the vacuole, the nucleus has been shifted in one corner. Okay, and the cell wall is very thin. Why? Because iska kaam hai support dena plant ko. Iska kaam protection nahi hai. Okay, so cell wall is thin, right? Vacuole is large, and there is a single nucleus. Since nucleus is present, automatically this cell is a living cell. Okay, the shape, if you would see, they are large, thin walled cells, either oval, circular, or polygonal in shape. Oval, circular, I guess you all know these shapes. What is polygonal? Poly means many. Polygonal means which have more than three sides. Okay? More than three sides is called as polygonal in shape. Such type of cells have a single large vacuole in them. Okay? Now, what is their primary function? If I would want you all to know, so definitely unka main key function is to give support to the plant body. Okay, any kind of support. So whichever part, like if I say they are present in the leaves, so yes, definitely there they would give the support to the leaf part of the plant. If they are present in the veins of the leaf, I hope you all understand the veins of the leaf, right? So if this is the leaf structure, these are the veins of the leaf. Okay, so if they are present at the veins of the leaf, yeah, so they are going to give the support to the vein of the leaf part. Okay, so basically they are going to support any part of the plant. Okay, so their key function is to give the support to the plant part, but that is only a temporary support. Apart from giving support, what is their other key role? They can also store food in whichever part they are present. For example, if these parenchymatous cells are present in potatoes, so there they can store starch in them. Okay, so this is one of the examples where in potatoes they are generally present, required to store starch. Right? Now, it is also being seen that they are present in leaves, and in leaves there are special type of cells which are called as mesophyll cells. Now, in mesophyll cells of the leaves, these parenchymatous cells contain chloroplast. Okay, what I am saying, when the parenchymatous cells of leaves contain chloroplast, then those parenchymatous cells in leaves are called as chlorenchyma. Okay, what are they called? They are called as chlorenchyma. And there, they are responsible for the process of photosynthesis. Okay, please students, this cholenchyma and chlorenchyma, they are two different things. Chlorenchyma is a type of parenchymatous tissue. Chlorenchyma is a type of a supportive tissue. I hope there is no confusion in your minds, right? Chlorenchyma, it is near a type of a parenchymatous tissue which is present in the leaves. When you see chlorophyll present in the leaf structure. Okay? Chloren, the word comes from chlorophyll. Actually, chlorophyll साथ है वो word. ठीक है? But हम बोलते हैं अगर chloroplast उनमें present है, तो हम उसको बोलते हैं chlorenchyma. It is obvious if chlorophyll is present in them, so they are responsible for the process of photosynthesis. Okay? So what important things you'll have to keep in mind if you want to learn about parenchyma, chlorenchyma and sclerenchyma is the structures. Okay, that is very important for you all to know. Continuing with the second type of the supporting permanent tissue, that is collenchyma. I'm repeating it again. It is collenchyma, not chlorenchyma. Okay? So, what is the peculiar characteristic of this type of tissue? As you can see the diagram, the cells are elongated, and the second important characteristic is the cell walls are thickened only at the corners. Throughout the cell, you will not see the cell walls are not thickened, and it is obvious the function here is not protection. Okay, the function here is to give support to the plant body, right? So here you would see the thickenings are there only at the corners. So this becomes a peculiar characteristics of this type of the tissue, that is collenchyma. Okay, now the cells are elongated with the thickened cell walls at the corners. Where are they present? Present mainly at the leaf stalks and below the epidermis of the stem. Here, unlike the parenchyma, whose role, there were two roles in parenchyma, if you all remember, we just did it, right? So I hope you all remember. There are two roles. One was to temporarily give support to the plant body, and second role was to also store the food in the plant body. As you also the example in case of potatoes, to store starch. Here the only role is to support the plant body. But what kind of support? Not the support which you all see in case of the trees which are standing for ages. No, not that kind of support. That kind of support is being given to the plant body by the third type of tissue, that is sclerenchyma, which we are just about to study. Here the kind of support what I'm talking is when the plants generally bend with the blow of the wind. Okay, so they don't break, right? They don't break. It is only the twisting or it is only the bending of the branch of the stem. Okay, so this bending is because of the presence of the collenchyma supported tissue which is present in the plant body. No doubt it is type of a support, but here the support which allows the plants in the bending or the twisting of its plant parts, mainly when there is the blow of the wind, right? This was all about the second type, that is the collenchyma. The third type which one need to learn is sclerenchyma. Now, the word scleros itself means hard. Okay, what do we need to learn about this type of tissue? Now, a sclerenchyma tissue is also being called as fibers, or they are also called as stone tissue, right? Why? That is because they are very hard. They are seen in two different forms. One is fibrous form, that is in the elongated form, and one in the cellular form. Okay, that is you can call this. This is called as the stone form. This is called as the fiber form of the sclerenchyma. The characteristics, the special characteristic which is seen only in sclerenchyma is, this is the type of the tissue which is dead tissue. Parenchyma and collenchyma, they were living cells. They were living tissue. They had nucleus in them, therefore they are living tissue. This is a dead tissue, therefore it does not have any nucleus in it. Okay. Second important characteristic, if you would see, they are very hard in nature, in structure. Third characteristic, they have very thickened cell wall, and the cell wall is made up of special type of the chemical which is called as lignin. Okay, so these are the three important characteristics. Also, the fourth characteristic, they are seen in two different forms. One is the fiber form, elongated form, long, and second is the narrow cellular forms, that is the stone forms. Okay, so these four different characteristics are seen in the sclerenchymatous cells. Okay, what is the function? Since they are very hard, now here they are majorly responsible for the mechanical strength and support to the plant body. Okay, no doubt the main woody stems, right, which actually can withstand any climatic change or any climatic condition, okay, any harsh conditions of the weather without falling. Okay, that is possible only because of this sclerenchymatous tissue which is present deep in the stem part, right? So apart from that, they are present in the veins of the leaves also. So their key role and the only role would be to provide the mechanical strength to the plant parts. Okay, some additional information about this type of tissue which I have mentioned in over here. Okay, I just mentioned it at the end in the bracket, which mentions that Robes mats. Okay, if you just see the texture, they are very hard, like a mountain climbing where you come across touching the rope. Those ropes are very hard if you touch them, and also the mats on which we sit. Okay, so these all are what material? They all are made up of plant material itself, but this plant material is what? They are made up of the sclerenchyma tissue of the plant. Okay, the hard shells of the walnut, right, coconut shells, okay, or any of the seed part, okay, the any hard part of the fruit or any hard part of the seed, what is it made up of? What type of tissue is present in that? By now you all know that that's definitely a dead tissue, but what is that tissue now called as? Now you all know the name of the tissue, that it is the sclerenchymatous tissue. And why is it hard? It is because of the thickened wall which is made up of lignin, deposition of lignin. Okay, this is the component which makes it thick and hard. Okay, I hope this concept is also pretty clear. Well, so here we understood about three important types of the supportive tissue. Okay, the parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Now, these three types of tissues are called as simple tissues. Okay, they are called as simple tissues. Why simple tissues? Because they are made up of only one type of cells. Ye tino tissue, as they are tissues matlab group of cells, to isme sare jo cells hote hain na ek hi type ke hote hain. Be it parenchyma, be it collenchyma, be it sclerenchyma. So if I'm coming across the word simple tissues, that means there's something which is called as complex tissues also, right? The study or what is complex tissue, that we need to understand in the conducting tissue part of this chapter. Okay, I would just want to quickly go through what we have done in today's slide. Also, I would want to combine it what we had done in the previous slide, including the part of the plant tissues. Okay, so that there is no confusion in your mind. So, starting with the plant tissues, we said that plant tissues are classified into two types, meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Meristematic tissues are those which include rapidly dividing cells. Permanent are those wherein the cells stop the process of cell division and they take a particular function. Okay? Meristematic are further divided into two types. What are they? Apical meristem and lateral meristem. Right? Permanent tissues. Permanent tissues are further divided into three types. What are they? Protective, supporting and conductive. Okay? Protective have no other types. Supporting have three other types. Parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. Okay? These three types together are called as simple tissues. Why? Because they are made up of only one type of cell. Right? Conducting tissues we are going to understand in the next slide. I hope these concepts are pretty clear with you all. Thank you.